I've come to just thank them and show my gratitude for the support I've received from the BJP party and senior leaders like Shri H.M. Krishnaji.
Now, BJP sources and your, the supporters of Congress who supported you in the Mandya, this is that she should get minister post in the cabinet.
See, supporters will always wish the best for you. We have to see how it unfolds, the whole scenario. Now the country has given a huge, amazing mandate to one party, which itself is a very healthy sign. I feel because now the government is strengthened, and you know they can do you know all kinds of welfare programs, and I am hoping to get a slice of that for my district now.
Even before the election, you said that I'll look after the election. I'll talk to my people, and I'll decide which party I should join. Are you going to talk to your people and?
Whatever I do will have to come from the people, and as of now, I don't know if you're aware of it, as an independent you are not allowed to join any party. There's no provision like which you can only support maybe on issues or policies, but you cannot join any party.
Has the Congress contacted you after you won?
No.
You had a huge support by the BJP, Congress as well, there in your constituency. Are you expecting that many of your political friends who came to Mandya, they also came here to meet S.M. Krishnaji at this moment? Do you think the Congress MLAs are also supporting you at this moment?
No, right now the election is over. I don't get your question as to how they would support me right now.
To get you the minister post?
I think we are jumping the gun kind of here. I mean, I'm still not, celebrated my victory, so to say, because I have to go to the people of Mandya and thank them. Thank them.
You fought against the chief minister.
I'm going on 29th, which happens to be my husband's birthday also, May 29th. So I'm going. I'll be going there and thanking the people of Mandya.
And you meet all the Congress leaders and JDS leaders also who supported you. They also work for you.
I don't know of any leaders, directly who have supported me. The cadres, of course, I would thank them.
Ma'am, final question is: do you think your stoic silence in the face of them actually coming out with expletive comments and all that, that really helped you? People saw that you can be civilized when you can have a campaign.
I'm sure that has sent out a strong signal to the people, but I would like to give credit to everybody who's worked hard for me. Be it the Congress party, rebel Congress party workers, the BJP party cadres who have put in a tremendous amount of effort, the farmers association, Raja Raita Sangha, as well as so many, other groups like the Dalit Sangha group, and many organizations and groups have come together to fight this election for me. So the credit has to go to them, plus Darshan and Yash, who put up such a strong front and, took everything I would say courageously on my behalf. All of that has gone into my
mind. One question is, what is your view on this coalition government? All the BJP is saying this is the time to throw away this coalition government. They are openly commenting. They are also saying like soon the BJP will be formed in this state.
They say the mandate is for them.
What is your view on that?
See, I think this is between the warring parties or whatever is happening here. I would not like to comment on that at all.
But you fought against
the chief minister. It was not the easiest part to you at this moment.
No, it was one of the toughest elections ever fought, and a lot of people didn't give me a chance at all, because today I came to know that 222 independent candidates have contested this as an election, out of which only one independent has won, and that is me.
Yeah.
So you can see the kind of odds that are generally stacked against an independent candidate.
Right after the election, now the Kumar Swami has
from
ordered.
India.
Right after
from
the
woman, women. First independent candidate after 52 years from Karnataka.
Now, right after the elections, Kumar Swami has ordered the spokespersons and MLAs not to speak to any media. Not to go to any media panel. So how do you see this?
I think it's now the media has to take a call, not me. I should be asking you this question.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.
If you like this video, bega like maadi, comment maadi, share maadi. Hagu YoYo TV Kannadavannu subscribe maadi.